For more than 500 million years, plants have been taking carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and converting it into carbon-based molecules that are the foundation of life on Earth. Nearly all of that carbon that plants fix is converted back into CO2, or methane gas, when the organic molecules that the plants produce are broken down by microbes in the environment or inside other organisms. But a small fraction of these carbon forms are longer lived, persisting in the environment for centuries or even longer, and thereby staying out of the atmosphere. Historically, this has led to vast amounts of carbon being stored in soils. However, much of this has been lost as a result of human activities like agriculture and urban development that alter ecosystems. We want to know how stabilized forms of carbon are created and how to restore the long-term sequestration capabilities of the soil so we can reduce atmospheric carbon using the tools that nature has given us. This research center, called RESTOR-C, is part of the carbon-negative Earthshot to develop methods to store large amounts of carbon at low cost for long time periods that can be deployed within a decade. We plan to do this by studying how plants and soil microbes work together to make different carbon-based molecules, and how environmental conditions like soil minerals, rainfall, and temperature affect how long they persist before returning to the atmosphere. Our toolkit at the center includes tiny chambers called ecofabs, where individual plants will be grown with precise control over their miniature environment, down to the specific strains of bacteria, fungi, and viruses present around the roots. To understand plant environment systems with more complexity, we'll be using our EcoPod, a Mini Cooper-sized vessel with room for multiple plants and multiple layers of soil. The EcoPod is equipped with air conditioning, irrigation, lights, and a variety of advanced sensors. It can be sealed shut so researchers can study how the plants and soil organisms within react under different simulated conditions and get an exact accounting of where carbon that enters the system ends up over time. These lab-based experiments will be complemented with findings from field experiments in California and New Mexico. And as the biologists and earth scientists on the team generate huge data sets about soil chemistry and gene expression, computational researchers will use machine learning tools to identify the different compounds, model where they came from, and predict which carbon products are likely to last 100 years or more. Our goal is to identify which plant genes, microbes, and soil and climate conditions lead to the production of persistent carbon forms. Someday, in the near future, these findings can be used to develop crop plants and beneficial microbes that rapidly restore soil organics. Such approaches, if broadly used, could help store massive amounts of excess carbon dioxide for generations. We're looking to the future, one with healthy ecosystems and a stable climate, by looking at the ground.